Hi everyone, I'm Navneet Krishnan, I'm a wildlife photographer, and in this video we are going to see why and how to set a back button focusing. So before we get started, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel so that you get daily one video to learn more on photography, Lightroom, Photoshop and Premiere Pro. So without any further delay, let's get started. As the name suggests, back button focusing. This simply means setting or focusing on a back button. So why do we do this? So who all do this? All these are the questions that pops up immediately when I say you should set a back button focusing on your camera. So this particular back button focusing technique, so that is basically used by the photographers of the particular genres of wildlife and sports mainly. So that is because they carry huge, so heavy lenses. So in case they want to carry such heavy lenses and they try doing half click, it is a tough job. They will not be able to do a half click while they are carrying such huge lenses. So to avoid such unwanted clicks and unwanted images dumped on their memory card, they use a technique called as the back button focusing, where they focus through the back button and click or capture through the shutter release button. So that is how the process particularly works. So I would say this is not just for wildlife photographers or the sports photographers. Anyone, like even an event photographer or a wedding photographer who just do not want to miss out on any particular event or a fast snaps, or you want to make such a fast snap of a with a great sharpness during an event. You want to make a candid photograph on an event. You are a wedding photographer. You can also go ahead and start using back button focusing. So I'll tell you how to do that. I'm using this particular camera, that is the Canon 550D, which is my basic camera. So in this, the back second button, that is basically where I set up the back button focusing to. So how do you do that? Many of the advanced cameras that you have something called as the AF and AE lock, which works similar to the back button focusing. In case you are using a basic camera such as this one, which does not have that particular feature, and you will have to set it to this particular star thing here to a back as a back button focusing, you can use this particular technique of going to menu and then you go to CN function, and then you set 0 to AF and AE lock. So I given you the path here, so you can just follow this path and you can set the back button focusing on your camera. So this is not just for wildlife. As I said, it's not just for wildlife and sports photographers. It can also be used as for wedding and event photographers as well. In case for a situation, I had this particular situation of a tiger walking to me, and it is like straight walking, and I don't want to miss the shot of the tiger looking at me. So in that case, I'll have to use a back button focusing, because I was using a 400mm prime lens that is too heavy for me to carry on hand and do a half click before I make a complete click. That is too heavy. So in that case, I go ahead with back button focusing, where I focus and I focus lock it on the face of the tiger. So wherever the tiger moves, or as the tiger comes closer, if it's like beyond the length of that 400-meter camera, it's not going to get focused. But if it is within the length of the 400-meter camera, it'll completely get focused, and the images can be made without missing any particular moment on that frame. So that is the major advantage of using a back button focusing. I hope this video was helpful. We'll come up with more amazing videos. Until then, stay tuned and follow me on Instagram. Thank you.